Hello guys, welcome to In 5 Minutes. In this presentation, we are going to see asynchronous counter. We have already seen asynchronous counter, which is also called as ripple serial or up counter. But in this session, we will see the down counter. So there is a small change between up counter and down counter. We will see in this session 3-bit down counter. So let us starting with the formula which we have already used, that is number of state is equal to 2 raised to m, and m is going to be the number of flip-flops. Let us say we are going to perform a 8-bit serial down counter in asynchronous type. So if m is equal to 3 and number of states are 8, so let me assign these states. Therefore, state diagram will be, since it is a down counter, so we have to start with the highest number. So 7 we are going to start with, because there are 0 to 7, 8 states are there. So highest state is 7, so 7 will go to 6. 6 will go to 5, 1 will go to 0, and finally 0 will go to 7. And as you see that there is a closed path, so you don't know from where to start or from where we have started. So we will set 0 as the reset state. So from going from the state diagram, we will, let us form a truth table. So this is going to be a truth table for down counter, and we have taken 3 flip-flops, so output of 3 flip-flops are taken in reverse order, that is QC, QB and QA, output of the flip-flops A, B and C. So starting from the state, let us say that 0, 0, 0 is the reset state. Afterwards, we'll move to state number 7 as per the state diagram. So this will be 7, 6, 5 and finally it is 0, 0, 0. Now, if you are going to observe, these are the equivalent decimal numbers for the states are given in this column. And if you observe this carefully, what you see here, the QA is continuously in toggle mode. For each clock cycle, it is going to be in moving state. First clock cycle, it is be in 7th state, second clock cycle, 6th and 5th state, so on. So if you see for each clock pulse, A is changing from 1 to 0, 0 to 1, 1 to 0, 0 to 1, 1 to 0, 0 to 1 and again 1 to 0. But same way, if you observe the QB, then whenever QA moves from 0 to 1, QA will change its state. Till the time QA was in 1, 1, 1 state, afterwards it moved down to the 0 state. Why? Because it is following QA. When QA is in rising edge, that is nothing but 0 to 1. So for rising edge of QA, QB will change. And this is the falling edge for QA, going from 5th to 4. And for 4 to 3, again rising edge of QA, therefore QB will move from 0 to 1. Again it will change its states. Same while going from state number 2 to state number 1, again QB will change. Now, same pattern is observed in QC also. When QB goes from 0 to 1 means higher state, or you can say rising edge, because from 1 to 0 it is a falling edge for QB and 0 to 1 is a rising edge for QB. So for rising edge of QB, QC will change its position from 0 to 1. Now if the same pattern is followed, QA is going to be get 1 in the upcoming clock cycle after the 0 state. So there is a rising edge for QA. Similarly, QB will also change because QA is at rising edge. So this will be 1. And since QB also in the rising edge, QC will change. So this is going to be your state number 7, and your whole pattern is repeated once again. So this is nothing but your asynchronous ripple serial down counter.